What is an object? In JavaScript, an object is a standalone entity which has properties and values. Now, these JavaScript objects are comparable to objects in real life. For example, think about a hotel. Now, if we would translate this to JavaScript, the hotel would be our object. And for instance, the name of the hotel would be the property which would contain the value of, let's say, Hotel Bellevue, if that were its name. Properties. Here we see the hotel object and it contains three properties: name, city, and rooms. And we can store values in those properties, so they're always a key and value pair. So we see that name has the value of Hotel Bellevue, City Zurich, and rooms 86. By the way, little quiz question if you've been watching our videos, why does 86 not have quotation marks? Let us know in the comment section below. Think of data types. So storing property and values in an object is all nice and fine, but most likely you will also want to get access of that information. And we do so by writing the object name dot and then the property name. Here we see three examples. So it would be if we have an object of hotel, hotel.name. If we have an object of car, car.make, or student.firstname. So always first the object name and then the property name. Here we see three different ways how we can create an object and assign properties. The first, here we're using the dot notation. So we're first creating our object, our hotel object. That's what we're using these curly brackets for. And then with the dot notation, we're creating these properties on the object and at the same time also assigning a value. So at the first instance, we're saying, okay, the value of Hotel Bellevue is stored in the name property of the object hotel. Then in the middle, we see the bracket notation. Here to create the object, we're using the new object. So we have a new empty object, and then we can use the bracket notation. And you see the principle. In the bracket, we find the property name. Now here we have to use quotation marks to create them, and then we're assigning the value, in this case a fiat, to the property of make, and so on. And lastly, we have the literal notation, and I tend to use this when I'm creating an object and I know what the properties are going to be from when I'm creating the object. So that's what I'll use. You just write your object name. So let student, and then you open up the curly brackets and you write the properties. And this is important. You see, we're not using quotation marks. Then we're using as a colon, then Jane, again in quotation marks, and then we're separating the properties from each other by applying a comma. So they're comma separated. And here you see these are the three different ways how you can write them. Now, depending on your script that you're writing, one might be more natural to use than the other. And sometimes it's just really up to your own preference. As I mentioned, for me, the literal notation is what I usually prefer writing. Methods. The definition of method is that it's a function associated with an object, or put differently, a method is a property of an object that is a function. Now, if you're scratching your head because this sounds a little bit weird or a little bit complicated, then I have an example for you. I've added a new property to our hotel object, namely book a room. And as you can see, keyword function. You might remember in the videos about functions, which I'll be linking right about now, we learned how to create functions and that they're kind of like little subroutines that run. So we see that this function is going to return the rooms. So this rooms equals this rooms minus one. So that sounds to me like someone is booking a room and we're checking how many rooms do we have, and then we're just subtracting one. And we run the function by writing the object name hotel, and then we're using dot notation hotel dot book a room. Let's not forget the parentheses since we're running a function. And then we would get back the value of 85, yeah, 85 exactly, which should be then stored in rooms. Okay, so this is just to show that a method is a function that is a property and it runs with the object. Now, if you're wondering, this, what is that this? Well, that's great because that's going to be our next segment. This. The keyword this always refers to the current object. Here in our example, we have two different hotels and each of them has the method of book a room. Now, if we look at the four last lines of this code snippet, we're seeing that we're running this book a room method on the respective object. And we're obviously going to get back when we say, okay, so show me the hotel Bellevue room, show me the value of that property. We're going to get back 85, respectively 24, because we ran this book a room method on the respective object. And the this within those methods, so that this.rooms, that always refers to that specific object, in this case, that specific hotel. So we see that this book a room method, even though both of the objects have them, are contained or are exclusive to that respective object. And the way that we do that is by using the this keyword. If you've liked this video, if you've learned something new, then please go ahead and leave us a like. Please go ahead and subscribe to this YouTube channel and hit the notification bell so that you don't miss out on our upcoming JavaScript for Beginners video. Speaking about upcoming video, the next one is going to be all about array and the most common methods that you need to know about.